Penguin Random House Audio presents Reforesting Faith, What Trees Teach Us About the Nature of God and His Love for Us. This is the author, Matthew Sleeth, M.D. Every tree has its enemy. Few have an advocate. J.R.R. Tolkien. Part 1. Laying the Groundwork. The Lord God took the man and put him into the Garden of Eden to dress it and to keep it. And the Lord God commanded the man, saying, Of every tree of the garden thou mayest freely eat, but of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil thou shalt not eat of it, for in the day that thou eatest thereof thou shalt surely die. Genesis 2:15 through 17, King James Version. Chapter 1. What Trees Teach Us. They are like trees planted by streams of water, which yield their fruit in its season, and their leaves do not wither. In all that they do, they prosper. Psalm 1, verse 3, New Revised Standard Version. I love trees. I always have. No one told me to love them. I just do. I love looking at them. I love sitting in their shade. I love hearing the sound of wind rustling through their leaves. But what can trees teach us? Specifically, what can trees teach us about the nature of God and His love for us? Nearly two decades ago, during a difficult season of my life, I began to search for answers to these questions. At the time, I did not believe in God. I was trained in the sciences as a physician, and my search eventually led me on a nature walk through the Bible. This book, Reforesting Faith, shares what I learned. Before you embark on this trail with me, be warned. My job, my home, my family, the books I read, even the state I live in, and the places I travel have all been completely changed by this journey through the woods. God's trees. Trees grow older, taller, and bigger than anything else on the earth. They have been with us since the beginning of time. We humans owe our very lives to the sap, bark, wood, flowers, and fruit of trees. We are their masters, yet they are our stake in the future. And trees are beautiful, on the tops of mountains, bending over the sides of rivers, ringing the boreal latitudes, dripping wet with equatorial showers, trees blanket our world. At night, when the air is clear, trees can be seen grouped together at the edge of the forest. Illuminated in silvery moonlight, they appear to have been stopped mid-sentence. All night long, they draw a deep breath, hold it for one count, and then from dawn to dusk, exhale life-giving oxygen. The smell of a pine forest on a hot day, the sound of palms clattering in a tropical breeze, the sight of yellow maple leaves raining down through an autumn sky, these are all evidence of trees giving praise to their Creator. For those with ears to hear and eyes to see, the enormity of the gift of trees impresses itself upon us anew each day. Only God can make a tree. Embarking on the Trail. Reforesting Faith is about trees in the Bible. Listening to this book won't make your credit card debt disappear. It won't make your teeth whiter or your hair shinier. This is not a self-help book. It's about gaining insight into why God placed our great-great-grandparents in a garden of trees and told them to dress and keep them. It will help you understand why George MacDonald, C.S. Lewis, J.R.R. Tolkien, and other great Christian writers cast the heroes of their stories as the protectors of trees and the bad guys as their enemies. For the majority of my life, I did not believe in God. That's not the case anymore. In fact, the trees in the Bible are a crucial part of what brought me to faith. Christianity is the only religion that weaves trees from one end of its sacred text to the other. Every important character and every major event has a tree marking the spot. There's a tree in the first and last chapter of the Bible, in the first Psalm, and in the first Gospel. Throughout this audiobook, we'll look at how the Bible uses trees to reveal spiritual truths about humanity and God. We'll even see how the Bible contains assertions about trees not discovered by science until the modern era. Christians bring trees indoors once a year to celebrate the birth of their Savior. But many believe that Christians are anti-trees. Why? This is one of the questions Reforesting Faith will answer. We'll go on a journey from Genesis to Revelation, looking at how God uses trees in the Bible. Who was the first person in the Bible to plant trees? Who was the first person in Scripture to deface a tree? Why did Jesus say that the kingdom of heaven is like a tree? Why are we told that trees will shout for joy when the Lord returns to judge the earth? Can trees really talk to each other the way they do in the Bible? Why do some people smile when they see a tree blowing in the breeze while others take no notice? Which has more trees, heaven or hell? These are just a few of the questions you'll be able to answer after listening to this book. Key trail markers. God's ways are made tangible in creation. Trees help us understand and see the nature and character of God. Our nature trek through the Bible will focus on several themes, such as God loves trees. Like God, trees are in the life business. Responsible stewardship is one way we can express our love and respect for God. Planting trees demonstrates love for our neighbors and hope for future generations. Trees help us regain our sense of wonder. We are going to cover a lot of ground together. We will journey to ancient trees that stood witness to major interactions between God and our favorite Bible characters. We will also explore the varied ways God used trees to foretell the coming of the Messiah. Finally, we will see how Jesus and the apostles used the language of trees to share the good news. Please note that in this book, the term tree will refer not only to living trees, but also to the items that come from trees, such as rods, walking sticks, staffs, wooden ladders, and the cross. We will also include parts of trees, such as fruit, seeds, roots, branches, and leaves. Further, bushes, vines, and other plants will do their part in helping us find God's deeper meaning in the context of the Bible. Join me on the walk. Every time our bejeweled planet completes another circle around the sun, God gives every tree on earth a new ring. Tick goes the clock, and another year goes by. This year, will we see the trees? Will we heed the call to protect them? Will we plant the small tree today that the next generation will climb and the following one will find shade under? Will we plant in faith? Will we be called oaks of righteousness? Isaiah 61:3. Two opposing forces are at war on this planet. One says, look to yourself, it's all about you. The other says, love God and love your neighbor. The man who said the latter claimed to be the true vine and the tree of life. Reforesting Faith is about what God loves. God loves trees. Join me on a walk through the Bible and be prepared to meet the one who loves trees. Chapter 2, The Bible's Trail of Trees. The land produced vegetation, all sorts of seed-bearing plants, and trees with seed-bearing fruit. Their seeds produced plants and trees of the same kind, and God saw that it was good. Genesis 1, verse 12, New Living Translation. Nothing beats the smell of a pine forest on a summer's day. No stillness is like the quiet of ancient redwoods at night. I can't think of a fruit grown on trees that I don't love. Trees look beautiful, they sound beautiful, they taste beautiful. The first tree I remember was a dogwood that stood at one corner of my parents' front yard. Its limbs cascaded to the ground, forming a hidden playhouse underneath. The bark was rough, the petals silky white, and the berries red and smooth. Perhaps if I'd grown up in the desert, I would wax sentimental about cacti, but I was raised in the rural town of Woodfield, Maryland. No hamlet has ever been more accurately christened. Woodfield was a place of forests, fertile soil, and pastures. As a youth, I walked for miles along the single-lane pathways made by Holstein cows and the twin paths made by the wheels of farm vehicles. I rambled through the woods.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.